live coding series. We're creating a website from scratch with Python, Django, and Wagtail CMS. We got to a new point in our app where we're going to build a new feature entirely, more or less entirely. We recently created a general purpose contact module, so that's going to allow us to store organizations and people who are part of the Western Friend community who have contributed to Western Friend in some way. Now we're going to extend that actually by creating a directory of meetings. So essentially it's a hierarchical kind of grouping of organizations in the Western United States, and they have meetings that occur once a year called annual meetings. They have meetings that occur once a week called monthly meetings, interestingly, and some of the smaller meetings are called worship groups. And monthly meetings belong to year meetings, and worship groups belong to monthly meetings. So we need to kind of model this in Wagtail. Now, on the main website, which is our reference implementation, that's actually the live website, we have this community directory, and it consists of multiple parts, and we're going to focus in on this part here, particularly these yearly meeting pages and listings. And so I'm part of a specific yearly meeting right now. And so every yearly meeting will have an introductory text, some details. I think this can be a free form text. I'll have to figure it out and talk with Mary about it. But this part is like interlinked data, essentially. It's more or less hierarchical. Underneath this yearly meeting are quarterly and regional meetings, actually, I forgot to mention those. And underneath these quarterly and regional meetings are monthly meetings and worship groups. and we sort of manually wired everything up here to display the exact types of information and type of contacts that we want. So we've told Drupal and CBCRM that in this block we want to display monthly meetings and worship groups that are related to a specific yearly meeting. With Wagtail, the content structure is more generic, and I'm trying to work out how to do this in a way that's flexible and simple without writing a full-fledged sort of, you know, contact management or CRM, constituent relationship management system, or hard coding these into the templates, these relationships and mean types. And so I'm not exactly sure how it's gonna emerge, but I'm gonna take it an initial try. So I'm gonna connect a Twitch highlighter in the chat room. When I open a code file, basically, if there's anything that any of the viewers in the Twitch chat have questions or concerns about, you can highlight a line of code by using the exclamation line command in the lower left hand corner of the stream video. You just enter the line number, it'll highlight it, and you can enter an optional comment. Trying another experiment today with Twitch, setting up a bot for the room, but it doesn't seem like it's going to work. It's like an IRC bot, but it's having troubles connecting to this channel. on the channel. So anyway, we'll come back to that another time. Just trying to do what I can to make the sort of chat more interactive, so it's not just like watching somebody live stream. We need to be participatory. I'm coming back, coming from coding on a website called Code Buddies, where all of these sessions are, you know, intended to be collaborative. You can do code alongs or tutorial sessions, but the point is that you're kind of working with somebody and involving other people in the process. Okay, so now I'm all set up. We'll go ahead and dig in here. So the first thing to do is my new app. I'm in a branch dedicated to this feature. If I have to throw this work away, I'll just have to throw it away. I don't really know how this is going to emerge, but let's go ahead and do it. Manage Pi. Startup community. Should have activated my virtual environment. So let's try this again. There you go. Alright. So this is the initial community scaffold. I'll just commit that. Done any preparation in advance in terms of research aside from what we've done in previous screencasts. So I'll get the WAG to docs. And what I'm kind of wanting to try here is to just extend this native page model, because if we look at I couldn't get it to extend the page model because I had to had difficulties auto-populating the title. And page model is a default model, or a model that comes with Wagtail. And it does a lot of work for you. So let me see if I can take a quick peek at that. So it inherits several other models. Essentially, I was able to inherit from these clusterable model, I think, and the index model. So that way it can appear in the search index. But when I tried extending the page, this title is a required field. And you can't auto-populate it based on other values at the point of save. I couldn't figure out, I got kind of stuck in a rut trying to figure it out. How to auto-populate the title from other fields, because these contexts don't necessarily have a title. They have either a given name and family name, or a given name if it's an organization. And so the title is sort of superfluous. However, for the community index page, we can inherit from the standard page model. I'm trying to figure out how to feature these specifically. Since what all of these are featured pages, I could set up a grid, have an introductory text where we could put these links, which is essentially what we're doing on the main site. A second block for the events, which will be another content type we'll be working on soon. And then have a grid of featured pages. And essentially the page template we'd be working on would be for a contact. It would have to be generic. Contact would have an introductory text, I guess. What I can do is create a page model for yearly meeting page and have a field that says yearly meeting, and you select the yearly meeting, then the page template can start populating details there. That would give us a good slug, a clean slug like this, where it wouldn't have to be nested. So yeah, let's give that a try. And I'll figure out the details of how to get the details in the template and whatnot as we work. So I'm just trying to think. So every time I go to the Wagtail source, this environment folder opens up. I keep forgetting about that. Text. Either featured events or just a query. In the context, so I override the context of that. And then 6. Or arbitrary featured pages. Be a grid. Now the problem that would arise there if you let a user define an arbitrary list of featured pages, this could go on. I'm not sure if Bootstrap would. They would automatically flow into rows based on the width of the child elements. That might be what it's doing here anyway. Okay, so let's start on the community page thing, community index page. So that's the home model. I just minimize this. Yeah, this is very similar. We have featured pages and an intro text. Some page types, there should be maximum of 1. And then I could override the context to get those events in there. So this is actually pretty much exactly what we're trying to do. Simplify it. Or like a magnet index page, things like that, but assuming I'm calling it future pages, but when I look at the contact model, it's not technically a page. Oh, yes, okay. But I'm going back to what I was thinking earlier. The yearly meeting page will be a page that has a reference to the contacts. Excuse me. So we're good to go there. Welcome to a new viewer. If you're going to interact or engage with the development process, feel free to ask any questions or make your comments in the chat. You can also highlight a line of code on the screen. I've connected a Twitch highlighter, so you just in the chat can type exclamation line, space, the line number, and then an optional comment. It'll highlight the line of code on the screen, and I'll read your comment. It won't highlight empty lines, so you have to make sure you're telling it to highlight a line with some code on. And those highlights will hang around until I dismiss them. They're not that big of a deal, so feel free to do that. Okay, so looks like we're going to be okay here. I will just define screen page, rich text field. We're having an intro text in all cases for consistency. Featured pages. Because some of these are static, but they're all going to be pages. I should just pull the page title and the page intro text. Yeah, something like that. Or even truncated intro text, whatever. This is another block. One of the things that nice plugins for Drupal is this thing called panels. You can create these little text snippets that aren't really a fully fledged content, just little blocks of content you can put around, and I believe Wagtail has something similar like that, but I'm not sure if we would just define this as a field or a snippet, or I'm not sure how we'll define this. You know, this could just be a paragraph. The thing is, the ordering of these fields is going to be a little challenging. With the intro text, I think this would just be an optional. Alright, so page types, let's leave this as an empty array for now, because those are not relevant here. It should only be one community page, and I don't need to override the context right now, but we'll leave it around so that I can get these events here at some point. This will be helpful because I think it'll be similar ordering them by the so I can know how to think about it for a second. A couple more pages to feature on the community page. Migrations in the database, talk about the structure and changes, apply them. This is something I do a lot. I have to actually add this community app. Find migrations. page, not to find it, and I need to import that from web to. No problem. Now, one thing I enjoyed with PyCharm is it would actually fix this for me, basically, with a click. So we need this. Not orderable. To my knowledge, we won't be using orderable. Although you might want to control order of these, but that's actually done through a different field. Figure it out. It's actually this field. Okay, we do need orderable. That it means I also need the second content type. It should just be page. That means this can't be specific. Well, like these can't just be generic pages with this being specific page type. Looks like we can't mix. Can't mix content types. Damn it, that's been something a little bit irksome. I'm trying to think of a way to do this really generically. We don't have to hard code the sort of the content into the templates and things like that into the, like, looking for specific contact types and stuff. Oh, I mean, nobody cares. Because I think these are listings. Okay, this is just plain HTML. These are just plain HTML. So yeah, they would be just regular pages. But this is a view. This comes out of the database. We're looking at contacts, and Wagtail doesn't have anything like this with where you can do this visual query building. So this either has to be hard coded into a template or made generic, like in a group by or something. I don't know of a middle ground. Hey chat, does anyone here have any experience with Wagtail or Drupal or any other kind of content management? What kind of tools do you use for these types of projects? So what I'll do, just for now, to get something down the road, is I'll do a yearly meeting. We know that that's going to be a thing. I have a Docker app running on 8,000, apparently it won't go, it keeps coming back. That's weird. So. See if that. Oh, I'll have to start on a different server apparently. Yeah, there's WCVK, it didn't show up. Now we're up and running locally. Let's preview the site. If you've been around on a few of the other live coding sessions, you'll probably recognize this, but log in as a test user. Might not create a super user. Or it's case sensitive. Of course. I was just trying to. Okay, so we haven't created a library page. So we'll go to that Wagtail admin. And then just go to the pages. Community needs to be able to be added here. So I'll go to homepage. I think black is going to format this code for me, put double quotes around it, so I'm going with that. It's going to automatically add the community page. Because it's the only remaining page type. And since it only allows one instance of that, it won't let me allow any, add any more. Okay, good. Let's go ahead and get the community page template. At least we'll get some progress made during this live stream. Welcome to the new viewer. If you'd like to kind of participate in the development session, it'd be much appreciated. Feel free to add in questions or comments in the chat. If you'd like to highlight a line of code, if you notice something's gone wrong or missing a comma or have a typo or just have general questions about the code, you can actually highlight the code using the command in the lower left-hand corner of the stream, exclamation line, space, a line number, and optional comment. It'll show up here and you notice like light green. It's not too obtrusive, invasive or whatever, but I'll see it and I can dismiss it, and it's just a good way to get involved. I'm also interested in what your all's experience and background is. Have anybody here worked with any content management systems or Django, Wagtail? What kind of tools do you all use for your projects? All right, so a little more tea. And we'll just do an outside-in development, starting with as close to what the user sees. So the template, and then work our way into the more complicated stuff, these relationships and stuff like that. That hasn't quite crystallized in my mind. The templates are common patterns that we can employ. This is, I have to remember this, that the field name should not be the same as your class names. The classes we're using. So for camel case, put these. I wonder if they mean that they just can't be the lowercase version of that or what. Yeah, they do mean that. Oh boy. Wagtail is pretty good documentation. I mean, I've been impressed. I haven't been left scratching my head too much. This is what we're needing here is the template. Okay, so you just gotta it after class, essentially. See if this works. So we got the same feel of the title and the intro, which is rich text. I might use this code as well, since we're basically following our page model. So now we've got the template in place, I can view this live. Make sure I got the name right. Let me just reset. There we go. So yeah, something about the... It didn't pick up the change. Maybe because that archer didn't exist when I ran it? I'm not sure what happened there. Alright, so we got the title going there. And then the intro. I don't remember if I had an intro. Oh, I didn't have the intro field. Section, it's not what I meant to be. So if anybody has worked with Django at all, you'll notice how pleasing this Wagtail admin is. The Django admin is really nice, but it's not designed for end users. It's Wagtail. It's specifically designed for content managers. So it's like a first class sort of citizen and Wagtail user experience. And all this, it does quite a lot of heavy lifting for you, so really elegantly and automatically. Alright, so now we've got this community page. It opens us in another tab, but there we go. So we have the intro text, the community, so that's working out fine. And last things, I'll just add it to this avenue. So that is under. Oops. Yeah, I think it's under the main templates directory. Navbar. these are just hard coded. I don't know of a cleaner way of doing this. Because again, I don't want to. I mean, we just gotta assume that there's gonna be some content in here. I don't have a plugin to manage these links. I'll try to build that out later. I have an item in the issue here. I actually duplicated the item, but a navigation menu configuration so that we can do this, you know, with like a page selector. And then all this will be configuration to the UI. But okay, so now we're going to do it hard coded. Okay. Wagtail doesn't come up with that out of the box. I asked about it. They said it was probably best for contrib space. And they said there's already a plugin for it. So we're at our community page, magazine library, and this just hasn't been added. What I thought when we looked at the content over here. I'll fix that in a moment. Media library is a new feature on this site as well. Okay, we got a few more viewers here. Feel free to give me a shout in the chat. Any questions or comments are welcome. I do enjoy chatting, just kind of get out of the focus mode. And if you'd like to highlight a line of code, to let me know if something's wrong, or if that you have a question about how something's working, you can use the exclamation line and the line number and optional comment to highlight. So make sure that the line highlight has some code on it. It won't highlight these empty lines. All right, cool. So let's go ahead and commit all this. Doesn't mean the lint, but okay, the community page. That's home page. Oh, come on. Sub page. Alright, so I decided to kind of assume that we'll be featuring yearly meetings on the community page. That's the status quo. That's what way it works right now. And we can change this up later, but I do want to get something going on. We want to have this site basically rewritten by July. So it's kind of a short timeline. There's a lot of stuff we still have to make a bookstore with. Payments, subscription, recurring payments in that case. This whole media library with faceted searching, this community section. This stuff that took us like 4 years in Drupal to iteratively develop. We want to have done in the next couple months. Refer back to the home page model. What we did here is we have this home page featured article. So we need two things here, but we'll start with this community page. Yearly meeting. If we do a foreign key, allowed you to select between a generic page, you know, two models basically. That would be pretty cool. Maybe that's a possibility. Get too far from the path from Wagtail, because it's kind of give us like free widgets for selecting these content and things like that. And I don't know how well this would be supported. It's 10 years old. Not that things in Django change drastically over time, which is another reason we're moving towards Django. So this is the Panda community page. This doesn't yet exist. And I don't know that we would need this. So this reverse related name. This will, when we're at the community page, we'll be able to get yearly meetings through. Or these documents, these community page yearly meeting documents, through this selector, and I could alias it here. Oh, this is it. So I'm kind of risking colliding with this. Thank you. This is not even a foreign gig, it's just the fact that the bar is a page model. That's funny. Yeah, so basically it's going to suffix it, which I did here. Because I think this is clean, this community page makes sense. So I just need to, okay, no worries. This doesn't really appear in the UI to my knowledge. Usually meeting page should have an intro and a title. That's our who are doing it. And these properties will be available, these are class properties that will be available in the template when we're rendering these out. So in other words, these cards will have a title and an intro here when we're rendering them into the Wagtail, the Django template. Okay, just had to think through that for a brief moment. But we're good to go. Get this model. So yearly meeting page. It's still gonna be in the community, I believe. So let's hop back over here already. So. And just an intro text. This is where we'll have a page selector widget to select an entity. This is about to be all ahead of me, but more or less this is all correct. And it was linked through this related name field, so that should be good to go. The last thing I want to figure out is how do Wagtail page select. So it's a foreign key to a model that is of a page. All right. So let's add the field here. Thank you. careful when we're copy and pasting. So it's a regular Django foreign key. That means we need to import. Import models. Oh. Oh. Yeah, that makes sense. Thank you, IntelliSense. So this will be our contact. App, and the model is named contact. Contact. Okay. User panel. Alright, so just saving that real quick and import it. Admin, edit handlers, import. Feed panel. Didn't want me to do is Drupal. Black is pretty strict and opinionated, and I'll just stick with what it recommends for formatting. All right, take a quick drink of tea. It's funny that this is different. It seemed like it would point to the same sort of model instance or model class. I'm gonna try it with the same model class, see if things work. On the community page now. I edit it, we now have yearly meetings, yes. When I add one, okay, so this is not working. Let me double check. We do indeed have yearly meeting in the contacts. So it could be. Foreign key is very generic. So that could be where I'm going wrong. But it gives us a related page. Ours is definitely a contact. This is an optional argument, it looks like. Oh, we're right, because contact is not a page. Oh, damn. Okay, so no problem. In this instance, we have to look at a magazine article. Because the magazine article has a link to the contacts. Parental meant to many. Well, let's look at the department. So this is good. And then how do we display the department? Complete panel. Let's try that. Yeah, because the, just for clarification, this community model, sorry, the content model, just to repeat, this might have slipped by earlier, is not actually inheriting from page model, so this page chooser won't work. I should have remembered that. So we have to use generic, more generic autocomplete. So this should be the field name, page type, or other models, yes. I think this is the one we're using. this is correct. Just need the import. And what I'm adding here is the community page. So I have to create an instance of a yearly meeting page. There we go. That's why I can't find anything. There's basically a proxy model here. It's just throwing a little bit of confusion. It'd be nicer if this could just be directly related. But again, they're in different collections, so. I'm just gonna have this little proxy here. Again, we might be throwing this whole thing out. But at least I'll have something to show. Nice. Looks good, looks good. Alright, now what template do we need? Pretty much the same thing as this. Yeah, it's working. Alright, we're an hour in. I think I could probably wrap these commits up. Hasn't been too bad of a struggle. I finished a pot of tea. I'll have some more time to reflect now on how to handle the child relationships, the hierarchical nesting, and of the meetings, and display of generic information, as well as how to render them on this page. I think it's going to be, I could actually do that as the last thing for this session. Yeah, let's do that. Let me get these commits though, before they get too far ahead of me. So basically we just did a bunch here. See, it's already getting pretty far ahead. These are closely intertwined, though. So I think we should be able to copy and paste some code here. I'm just going to be focusing now on the templates, specifically the community page. And I can copy from the home page template where we grab feature article. just need a row with a header. Yeah, I don't need to be so worried about code reuse because this is the first time we've written this. So it'll be something like, let's get our handy dandy Bootstrap card. I think that's what they're calling them now. Let's mark up and paste. Wish it wouldn't do that. I wish it would just have proper indentation on base, but okay. We don't need an image. Title should be should be the link. This is a gotcha I've done many times. Since the title is part of the Wagtail page model, you can grab it off of any page model instance. But any page model, any class that inherits the page model and you add fields onto that, you have to access it through this specific. I don't know the underlying reason for that. I think I would just do a division of 12, and there's 3 year meetings. So 12. So 4 columns. Where's the layout? Grid. Huh. Well, this is cool. I don't even have to do the math anymore, apparently. Check one thing, it's I don't have any. I'm gonna make sure I have a yearly meeting saved here. Okay, I don't. So that's the problem there. Okay, second thing is it's not viewing it. Not rendering it. Let me make sure that it's saved. There it is. You can add multiple. Good, good. The second thing is to do it back into the model, make sure I'm using the right. That's the problem. There we go. So if there are some yearly meetings, like greater than 0, then render them. There it goes. Okay, looking good. Now, this is a block element. So why doesn't it? Two things that are irksome. What am I doing wrong here? This should be an H3 anyway. don't think this works. Really, it should be. That's strange. By default, I block. And okay. I mean, you don't want to do this. This is kind of kludgy. It's like, why do I have to do that? Okay, so there's something else going on here. This should be here. Four. So this is broken. Code is. Oh, there we go. That's that. Okay. Yeah, some markup. To move this out of the row. Something about headers and rows, I think. I don't know what goes on. Okay, now what's up with this intro text? It's the last detail here. So pushing right up against the page edge, which is strange. Okay. So let's check content. Some intro text. So, you know, I might be wrong about this specific, but that's bitten me before where I had to use that property. Let's see if it works without it. let's go ahead. I think it is actually trying to get that. Line 76. Models. Intro. Yeah, so something's up with my model. Alright, no problem. Good thing I tried this today while it's fresh in my mind. Yeah, that's all. Let's try and access this intro property, which is reaching into wrong, or using the wrong field, essentially. This is the foreign key. Yeah, all right, good. It's working properly. And the last thing is pass that the rich text filter. These are Wagtail pages, so I can use the Wagtail page shorthand. So we go to magazine templates. Article summary. We're just using this tag. Something like this. Interesting, more elegant way of doing this. Because this is a URL that I defined, but there's a Wagtail helper. URL, that's it. I think all page URL needs is the entity. So the user meaning in this case. That should work. Looks silly, but that's the deal. I think this will work. Yeah. All right, we're good to go. And it's previous community, but that's okay because it's a hierarchy of content. We're looking good. And there may be a way. To to do this more elegantly, but in any case, I'm using this for loop, I'm using the same name. And then each of these has a property because it's a proxy model. Okay, that's a little bit kludgy, but it looks good. It's readable. That's a good stopping point. Okay, well, this has been another live coding session. Creating a website from scratch with Python, Django, and Wagtail CMS. I appreciate the Twitch viewers for coming along on the journey. Anybody on YouTube, if you're watching this video, feel free to leave a question or a comment, and I'll try to respond to you promptly. I do, you know, appreciate any kind of feedback. If I can improve my code style or the delivery of the content or any other suggestions, I'm welcome, or I'm open to suggestions. All right, well, thanks very much for watching, and have a great day.